Hi all, here I am discussing about big data privacy, big data visualization, big data pipeline. Let's start with evolution of big data. Big data that requires more processing resources to produce value than are available within the constraints of the current business problem. Big data is similar to small data but bigger in size. It having data bigger and requires different approaches, techniques, tools and architecture. Its aim is to solve new or old problems in a better way. Big data is a blanket term for any collection of data sets so large and complex that it becomes difficult to process using on-hand data management tools or traditional data processing applications. Let's move to the path to big data. Data management professional. It is concerned with managing data and the infrastructure which supports it. Key technologies and skills to focus on: Apache Hadoop and its ecosystem, Apache Spark and its ecosystem, SQL and relational databases, and NoSQL databases. In the case of data engineer, the technologies and skills required for data engineering and data management are similar. However, they each use and understand these concepts at different levels. If the data management professional is the car mechanic, then data engineering is the automotive engineer. Business analyst, it requires a unique set of skills. Key technologies and skills to focus on: SQL and relational databases, NoSQL databases often requires commercial reporting and dashboard package know-how and data warehousing. Machine learning researcher or practitioner, those are crafting and using the predictive and correlative tools used to leverage data. Statistics and programming are the biggest assets to the machine learning researcher and practitioner. Key technologies and skills to focus on: statistics, algebra, calculus, learning theory. Programming skills like Python, C++ or some other general purpose languages. Data-oriented professional is concerned primarily with the data. Key technologies and skills to focus on: statistics, data visualization, communication skills, programming languages like Python, R, SQL. Let's move to the big data pipeline in depth. The real-time big data pipeline should have some essential features to respond to business demands, and besides that, it should not cross the cost and usage limit of the organization. There are some key points that we need to measure while selecting a tool or technology for building a big data pipeline, which is as follows: components and parameters. Components of a big data pipeline are the messaging system, message distribution support various nodes for further data processing, data analysis system to derive decisions from data, data storage system to store results and related information, data representation and reporting tools, and alert system. Important parameters that a big data pipeline must have: compatible with big data, low latency, scalability, flexibility, economic diversity. In a big data pipeline system, the core processes are the messaging system and the data ingestion process. The messaging system is the entry point in a big data pipeline, and Apache Kafka is a publish subscribe messaging system, work as an input system. For messaging, Apache Kafka provide two mechanisms utilizing its API, producer and subscriber. Once the data is available in a messaging system, it needs to be ingested and processed in a real-time manner. There are two types of architecture followed for the making of real-time big data pipeline: Lambda architecture and Kappa architecture. This is the block diagram of Lambda architecture. There are mainly three purposes of Lambda architecture: ingest, process, query real-time, and batch data. And Kappa architecture. Here, streaming data enters to the stream process, then moves to the serving layer and outs queries. Big data visualization. It involves the presentation of data of almost any type in a graphical format that makes it easy to understand and interpret. Big data visualization techniques offer a fast and effective way to review large amounts of data, spot trends, identify correlations and unexpected relationships, present the data to others. Various data visualization examples include linear, that is list of items sorted by a single feature, 2D planar geospatial cartograms, dot distribution maps, proportional symbol maps, counter maps, 3D volumetric, 3D computer models, computer simulations, temporal, timelines, time series chart, connected scatter plot, R diagram, circumflex chart, multidimensional pie chart, histograms, tag clouds, bar chart, tree maps, heat maps, spider chart, tree or hierarchical, have dendrograms, radial tree chart, hyperbolic tree chart. The big data tools marketplace reveals the presence of big names including Microsoft, SAP, IBM and SAS. But there are plenty of specialist software vendors offering leading big data visualization tools, and these include Tableau software, Qlik and TIBCO software. Big data privacy. While big data offers a variety of benefits to organizations of all shapes and sizes, it also comes with several noteworthy privacy risks, including data breaches. It occurs when information is accessed without authorization. In most cases, data breaches are the result of out-of-date software, weak passwords, and targeted malware attacks. Keeping software up to date, changing passwords often, and educating employees on best security practices can all help prevent data breaches. Data brokerage. The sale of unprotected and incorrect data is considered data brokerage. Before buying data, organizations should do their research and make sure they are receiving data from a reputed provider that offers accurate data. Data discrimination. Since data can consist of customer demographic information, organizations may develop algorithms that penalize individuals based on age, gender, or ethnicity. Organizations should always have a thorough and accurate representations of customers, account for biases, and put fairness above analytics. There are certain strategies organizations can use to protect big data. Several of the best practices for maintaining the privacy of big data include: employ real-time monitoring. This way they will be aware of a problem as soon as it happens and can take appropriate steps to resolve it right away. Implement homomorphic encryption. Homomorphic encryption is a form of encryption that allows users to compute data without decrypting it first. This form of encryption should be implemented to store and process information in the cloud to prevent organizations from revealing private information to outside vendors. Avoid collecting too much data. Only the data that is absolutely necessary should be collected. An organization may not need the social security numbers of their customers. Customer login, usernames, and passwords may only be necessary. Prevent internal threats. Organizations are also exposed to internal privacy risk from angry or simply uninformed employees. Therefore, it's essential to educate all employees on best practices for ensuring that our privacy, like changing passwords frequently and logging off unused computers. Thank you for watching.